All right, the manager of Ajax, Hikari Mugen, will now take questions. First off, Ethan Vlogs asks, is there reports that Boer is leaving Ajax due to not playing enough games this season? Is this true?
For the last time, under the previous manager, Big Bad Boer did not get enough of the play time. But underneath Hikari Mugen, Boer is getting plenty of the play time. And he is very happy. No selling the big bat Boer son.
Okay. Ergen Kelly asks, as you know, you're playing your second team of youngsters in the Champions League. But if the youngsters get a battering against big opposition, it may affect their confidence. What is your input, Mr. Mugen?
If a big loss affects their confidence, then they do not have what it takes to be a professional player here at Ajax.
All right, thank you. Marco Cast TV asks, after Hakim Ziyech's goal, celebrating in front of his former team, have you said any to him after the match?
Ziyech-san said to me after the match that he do not appreciate very much the way that the twin fans treated him when he left the team. So he has simply made his feelings known, and he will do it again. Good for him.
All right, final question. AFCA1900 asks, are you planning on giving Isak playing time in the league after his amazing Champions League performance?
With performances like that, from Isak-san, Dolberg-san might have some competition. And competition is always a good thing.
All right. Thank you. That's all the time that we have. Thank you, Hikari Mugen. You're free to leave.
Arigato. And sayonara desu.
Welcome back, you lovely words. So that's the FIFA 17 IS career mode. Now, guys, you went ahead and voted 168. You guys voted for Leon the Jamaican Bailey to be profiled in this episode. But right before that, I must humbly ask more than ever that you smush your nipples into that like button, because YouTube has changed the algorithm again and it's scaring the bejesus out of me. They want interaction, they want comments, they want likes, and that's what's going to keep channels alive. So for a small creator like me, please, Weirdo Army, all you loyal weirdos, please go ahead, smash out the likes. Go ahead and leave the comment. If you can't think of anything, leave the hashtag FistMeYouTube in the comment section down below. Thank you guys so much. I love all y'all. Let's get into this. Leon Bailey, if you've seen from the highlights I've already shown, electric when he's going with these, when he's got the ball. He's Jamaican. He's the Usain Bolt of FIFA, okay? He can sprint for days. He could run for days. He does have some weaker points. His high points, his dribbling, his pace. But his finishing and his crossing leave a little bit to be desired. As you can see, he could skin a man, the no-touch dribbling. Look at him skip past. He reminds me of like a young Sterling or kind of like a Memphis in the fact that he has the ability to take on a player with ease. He's got the pace to absolutely fly by. If he's ahead of you, he's gone. And he could pit away the odd chance of getting the right. And you see flashes. Like, look at that. He's got a dynamite left foot. He's got a blunderbust of a left foot. But you know, when he tries to cross it in, it's hit or miss. Sometimes he delivers a goodie, sometimes he delivers a poopy. You know what I'm saying? But
what?
When things align, what? Thundercut from distance from the young Jamaican. Look at that, setting up on the technique. And he can bang him, man. It's not just like a one-shot thing. He definitely has that long shot trait, and he has the ability to skin a keeper on his day. Lovely tuck pass over there. And then when he sets up, he's, look at that, with his right foot as well. He's got some massively, he's got some lead weights, man, in those boots right there. As you can see, only 19 years of age, 4-star weak foot, 4-star skills, high medium work rates, and he's left-footed, can play on both sides if you saw him playing that. Very, very excited for this kid. He's not a finished product yet. He isn't. But I'm excited to see where he goes. Potential, I think, is in the 87 to 88 range. And unfortunately for him, he just drew the bad luck of the straw. We have two cup games in this episode as opposed to one league game. So in the cup games, I tend to play, you know, more of the second teamers, especially in the Champions League. Very, very crucial Champions League bout, because we're probably not going to win that bout up against the rematch up against Borussia Dortmund. So it's do or die for us to advance in Champions League in this episode. And Leon Bailey can't help us in that one. But we have Hakim Ziyech's form a team in 20th in, I believe, the Domestic Cup. I'm not even going to try to pronounce it in this episode. Please let me know, Dutch speakers, how I pronounce your Domestic Cup in the comments down below. As we get into it, I was requested by one of you subs to go ahead and showcase basically the lineup before we go into the match. So here you guys go. Shona, a lot of the newbies in here. Lawton, Cherny, Adamilson, Tete, Fearhover, Sinkraven playing the left back position. A lot of you guys have been letting me know play Sinkraven in the left back position. And Onana does get a start. This isn't Champions League, so I don't have to, you know, start only my second teamers. So there's a little bit of a mixing there. And Onana is going to get as many starts as possible because I want to go ahead, raise his, up his potential, up everything about him. I just like him. He's a fine young gentleman. I think he got his, fifth, clean sheet, consecutive clean sheet over the weekend or something along those lines. I'm following, I'm becoming a casual Ajax fan. I follow their YouTube channel. I don't know what they're saying on their YouTube channel, but it's cool. You know what I'm saying? Now, Isak, who had a delightful last episode linking up with Cherny, goes for the chip! Cherny, out of nowhere! Rakov, what you doing, son? You cheeky bugger, you. And, there was a myriad of chances in the first half, right? Again, Mbappe Lawton, this is becoming old news coming in, but can't get the shot away, cannot put anything away to save his life. He's cursed, man. Then Adamilson from distance, non-preferred left foot right there, and skims past the side crossbar. A great save from Onana! Oh, big boy thing, but we can't latch onto the rebound. A simple cutback cross, and a tap-in. Onana did extremely well, showing his range and athleticism to block that first shot, but his defense let us down. Remember, this is the second team defense right here. Sinkraven, I know he's... Oh, that's actually... It's going to go down as an own goal there for who? Galdemez over there. The Chilean trying to track back, do his best, but sometimes when you try to clear in those desperate situations, you end up putting it in the back of the net, and that's exactly what happened to the Chilean sea bass. Right there. We're going to have to play from behind, but Unal linking up beautifully. Twins want revenge for what we did to them in in the league. Look at this, totally unmarked in the box, and should have done better, son. Should have done better. But that is pretty much going to be things. 75th minute, though. Isak steal away, pings it, top ends, putting the team on his back. Oh my goodness. Isak. How you do this to me? You're doing things to my body. You turned me into a woman because I am sexually attracted to that finish right now. What the hell? Look at that. Just stealing away from the defender. Strolls into the box like nobody's business. And keeping the composure. Just calm, cool, selected. Curled inside. Beautiful. Oh, picturesque. Isak, man. We mentioned him in the, the PCQ. Dolbergson is doing quite well, but if you're gonna look, can Isak get his second? Can he get an assist in Cherny? Great save right there. Put it in, but needed a bit more power. Then Osadebe gets onto it, but he doesn't have the highest, hits. He doesn't have the highest hits in the world. And this is a cup match, so apparently there's no replays like the FA Cup. So we're gonna go into extra time. This is gonna be a little bit sketchy. Now Isak onto the ball, 91st minute, over to Mbappe. What is he gonna do? Cuts it back inside to Isak, fires it crossbody, and this is a decent enough shot, but you're not gonna win them all. He's gonna flip it into the middle, and we pop onto it, Mbappe onto it again, put it across to who else? Hakim Ziyech. The Moroccan hybrid warrior. And of course, up against his former team, he's gonna be damned. And thank you to the subs that let me know that he's actually celebrated up against both of his former teams, because apparently he received a lot of flack from those teams' fans after he left. Anyway, man, live your truth. There is an unspoken rule that you're not supposed to celebrate up against your former team, but if that's how you play, I love seeing emotion in the game, man. If that is your truth, if you truly feel that way, don't be fake. Just let it be known. Man, fuck that team. You know what I'm saying? And fuck their fans. I did the best that I could. And if you ain't happy for me putting on one, then screw y'all. And look at this. Cherny cutting inside to Ziyech, who pings it off of the post. Who is there to follow up? Isak with the brace. The next. Zlatan Ibrahimovic in training, ladies and gents. Remember, he is just a baby. This kid is just a baby, and he can't stop scoring. His stats, honestly, are not that spectacular. But there's something about him, man. He keeps on finding himself in the right position. It was a tiny little tuck away. And there you go, a brace and the winner from Hakim Ziyech. And we advance in the Dutch Domestic Cup. That's what I'm going to call it right now. The Dutch Domestic Cup. The DDC, if you will. And look at that. Oh, the dejected faces of Twente. Twice in, I believe, a month that we go ahead and put them to sword. They battle valiantly. We had a comeback. And this one, we showed resilient and grit, which is what I would like to see, especially from a young bunch. I don't think anyone in this team is over the age of 24, 25, maybe Klaassen. Oh, I guess Schürrle played in this one, so that is definitely one. Isak going ahead, netting two goals and getting man of the match with a 9.2. And yeah, that is pretty much going to be it. Ziyech getting netting the other one. Decent showings from Mbappe Lawton as well. Czerny was a little bit disappointing. Got into good positions, you know, almost got the assist a couple of times. Unlucky for him. His stats should have shown better, but absolute domination. 19 shots, 9 on target. I mean, 13 shots, 9 on target. Good stuff from the Ajax fans. We stay ahead of the league. Now 5 points clear atop of the Eredivisie with our main rivals PSV and Feyenoord. You know, further distance now 11 points clear of Feyenoord, our deepest rivals, our most heated rivals, and I'm going to give them my meat when I next see my rivals. All right, enough of me and my fantastical, terrible rhymes. We're in the league. We're playing up against, Sparta Rotterdam. I did a little bit of research on them. I couldn't even find them. Are they a newly promoted side? Because I couldn't find them in the Eredivisie last season. But now we get to feature the main man of this episode. Leon Bailey, Dolberg, Traore. A lot of the big names you guys already know. The big boys are in here. Onana, I believe. In the midfield is the usual suspects, the big bad Bazaar. Sparta Rotterdam is featured in 9th place right here. And I believe they're 9th place in the Eredivisie right now. So there you go. Art imitating life, if you will. And this is our main lineup. Dolberg, Hakim Ziyech, returning once again. He was only had a sub-in spell in the last game. Klaassen, the dunker, the badonkadonk man himself, anchoring that back line. For Sparta Rotterdam, I'm not going to lie, I don't really know a lot of these kids, but we're going to go ahead, get into this. 5th minute, nice little tuck away, but can't find anything onto that. We're going to go back into the middle, though. Good knockdown. And then, once again, we're going to apply pressure. Hopefully, they break underneath this weight. Bazaar linking up. Dolberg gets into a good position. Klaassen kind of caught between two minds. And the defender bails him out right there. Thought about the pass. Didn't. Tucked it away. Then tried to go away. He's not the most agile player. But still, the defender steps in. Clips one of the ankles. And Klaassen is on the ground. Who do we have step up? Mr. Dolberg-san. Going ahead, netting himself another goal. Do the Dolbergs. I can do it too. Lovely, lovely stuff. Strong stuff. Calm, cool, collected. I know he only has 46 composure, but I mean, seemed pretty composed right there. Unfortunately for him, if you want to use him, he's better than ever. After scoring that hat trick, he got another upgrade from FIFA. So his composure is up to like 78 now. Yeah. Thanks, EA, for doing that later. Why give him 46 composure in the first place? Now Hakim Ziyech, beautiful play back to Dolberg. Intricate tiki-taka by the Ajax men. And then good run onto this. Bazaar hitting it to the back post. Traore probably would have gotten saved even if he did put that on target. But dangerous stuff. Now the Dendonka-donk man getting it in. And we had a myriad of chances. But if we can't put it away, you know what happens. We put it on the other edge. We get flipped onto the other side. And that should have been a goal. Good wind, more like bad wind. Am I right? But I mean, nah, it's just shit wind. Look at that. That is audacious. That is some. You should cut a man after he has a miss like that. And we're going to go ahead. Should be nil. Should be 1-1 going into the halftime. But we're going to keep it 1-0. Hold that lead. It was cagey in the second half, man. We were going to get chances, you know, here and there. That's what I'm talking about, Bailey, man. Look at that. Can't even keep it in. I don't know. He just didn't show up this episode. It's like he didn't get the. Ziyech got the memo, okay? Bazaar apparently got the memo. Look at the strength. Once again, another man mentioned in the press conference showing up, man. He heard that, you know, maybe we're going to be selling him. And look at it. The strength to get past two defenders and then slot it crossbody past the keeper who is rushing out. What? That is ridiculous. But that is what Bazaar can do to you, man. He's a complete midfielder. He can score, he can defend, he can pass, he can do it all. And linking up Dolberg over to Klassen.
You stay classy.
You stay classy indeed. Doing the Mesut Ozil celebration. And I want to go ahead and get this a little bit more involved, guys. I think that every time like a certain player should score, they should have their own personalized, you know, celebration. So let me know in the comments down below what celebrations should Ziyech have. I kind of like him having the dab. What should Dolberg have? I kind of like the Dolberg face, you know, the strength one. But that's the same as like Isak, who kind of does the same one. So I kind of want to mix it up. Every time a person scores, I want them to have their own kind of personalized, you know, celebration. I'll try to memorize it and that type of stuff. But good stuff. Early on, you know, it was closer, but quality eventually showed in the second half. We tend to wear teams down with their amount of chances, and then, you know, the mental acuity is lowered. We beat them down. We beat them down with our, you know, tiki-taka. We wear them down physically and mentally. And of course, eventually when they break, the floodgates open. Another 3-0. Beautiful stuff. Onana, another clean sheet, which is what I like to see right here. But Sparta put up a decent chance. You know, they had 6 shots, 2 shots on target. Should have at least scored 1 goal. Let's be honest here. And we're going to go ahead and give Bailey his due. 4 training sessions for him. Try to go ahead, get him up already to a 77, which is very nice. Almost up to a 78. Probably be, well, maybe 80 by the end of the season. That is my hope. But we'll see. We will see. Dortmund sit atop the league, and we actually are in second place after getting our ass whooped in the first 2 matches. But we got 2 matches left. CSKA Moscow, who we put to the sword in the previous match, but that was at home. Now we have to face them away. Always a notorious place to go and play on a cold Champions League night. This one is going to be interesting. Indeed, they are on paper, you know, statistically a better team, but through our, you know, our good amount of our focus on training and the players that we have brought in, I think we have playmakers enough to go ahead and rival them. But if we were starting our first team, I think, you know, obviously we could definitely put on a show. But since we were starting the second teamers in this one, you know, Isak, I need you to show up, buddy. Mbappe, Lawton, Cherny, all y'all really need to show. And especially our defense, not a lot of pace. It was a struggle keeping up with, I don't think they're even that fast, you know, wingers and players. The CSKA Moscow, it's just we were that low rated at times. But Isak, good patient play. This is the game that we're gonna have to play. Tiki Taka streaking in. Terrible lax defending from CSKA Moscow. And Van der Beek goes ahead and just waltzes in. Terrible, terrible stuff. And that is the 4-3-4. What am I talking about? 3-4-3 things right here. Because look, just falls asleep at the back. I think that's probably their CDM. Whoever 66 is, get him off the pitch, because that is just lax. That is absent-minded. And we go ahead and sneak the goal, and you already saw him right down in the middle. Ultra defensive. I am not going to show all the defensive highlights, but this is it. They have Asina Troy, who's like 6 foot a million tall, and they just kept on crossing it in. Trini goes ahead and goes in. Isak does it again, steals it away, puts it on to nothing. Hey man, you're not gonna play Zolberg son, but finishes like that. Did well to get into that position to steal it away. Apparently you're a sneaky man with that tall frame of his to go ahead and steal things away. Could be, you know, a valuable weapon in his arsenal that not a lot of strikers have, because he's got that pace, he's got that length of boot, if you will, to go ahead and maybe pinch a couple off, and that could be his way to get more goals. Now Delict goes ahead, steals away, and it was, you know, I sometimes say it's like, oh, it was a cagey battle, it was a defensive battle. I was sweating bullets in this one, man. I was doing my best. I was running with like a bat out of hell in this one, closing fires, trying to shut down fires all over the place, trying to get anything going. They were crossing it into Lucina Triori, every opportunity that they have, trying to get it onto the 6'7" monster's head. And it was a boring second half. I couldn't get anything going forward from the moment that we scored. The AI turned up, but we were able to persevere, and we get extremely, extremely well-deserved 3 points. It wasn't the fanciest games. I apologize for the absolute craptastic gameplay, but a heroic effort from this team, the second team, no less, up against, you know, in enemy territory, traveling, you know, many, many miles with our second team. We actually did dominate possession, but look at that. We had two shots, one shot on target. One of them happened to go in. And, you know, great performance, right? Tim Krul coming out and, you know, claiming a lot of those, you know, crosses into the box up against 6'7", Lucina Troy. I can't give enough credit to these young lads. They showed a lot today. And I was super surprised that we were able to get. I would have been happy with the draw, but to get a 1-0 win, these are the games that you have to win. You know, if you want to be a great team, you need to grind out results. And that was what it was on show. We're playing the 3-4-3. And usually it's going to be fireworks. But in this one, this is just what the doctor ordered. Hopefully it's enough. I think that should secure us position in the next round of Champions League. And I'm going to bring it up to you guys right here on a vote. You know, go ahead and vote as well on what player to profile. But also, vote on if we make it into the Champions League round. A lot of you guys have been asking, should we be allowed to use our first team? I'm going to give you the option of, like, I can use, let's say, 5 first team players, or all first team players, or no, you still have to use the second teamers. That'll be your choice. And anyway, guys, once again, go ahead, leave a like, because I'm a dirty, filthy whore. I'm just gonna be begging, because that's the game that we have to play on YouTube now. It kind of sucks, but there you guys go. So if you love me, you know, in a homosexual or non-sexual fashion, please go ahead and leave a like. My name's Bonus. I just put out a video telling you guys. I'm sorry. I just put out a video telling you guys how to sign players out of the transfer window. Go ahead and click right there. Ding. Check out the last episode on this. I'm gone. Let's be modest. Hope you guys have a wonderful day. Stay yourself. Stay weird and all that stuff.